Good morning, Jerome. This is CSPN. I'm Brandon Infante, your host, a.k.a. Cod McKnight.
And I'm Kemp. Let's watch this video from Sweck and Poppy called Sports Swap.
Hi, I'm Alyssa, and I play flute in the Dublin Jerome Marching Band.
And I'm Carson. I play tight end and defensive end for Jerome football.
And this is Sports Swap.
Practice usually, so we kind of just warm up by playing like the F descending scale and chromatics, and then after that we run through our show. We have four acts this year, and so it's a lot of work because we have to memorize how we march and where we are on the field. So it's a lot of work, but it's also a lot of fun.
So at a normal football practice, we get stretched and like warm up and whatnot.
Oh yeah.
And then we'll do like routes with wide receivers. And sometimes like we'll just like line up and do like on the line hitting drills and whatnot.
That's fun.
But so we'll just like run some routes real quick.
Okay. Oh no.
Hail Mary. Go.
Jeez, that was atrocious. All right.
Yeah, that was pretty embarrassing. Now, let's check out a video made by Pick and Hayden on DFL.
The Ohio High School Athletic Association reports a decline of 2,000 football players across the state over the last 10 years. This trend can be even seen in Dublin. The city's youth football program, DFL, has continued to see a decline in participants over the last few years. Dublin Football League coach Rich Schell has been coaching in Dublin for over 15 years.
But the numbers are dwindling, that's for sure, in tackle football.
My first year in the league was 13 years ago, and when my son was there, my oldest son, there were 16 teams in the senior league. Then my next son, there was 12. Then my next son, there was 8. And now there's only 6. What is it? I don't know, but I would probably have to say it's something to have to do with the concussions.
Well, then Jerome head coach Bob Geswich. Try to explain the decline in numbers.
You have rookie tackle, which big programs like Menor and St. Ignatius are putting in. Me personally, I know my son's not going to play tackle football until middle school. I'd rather have him try other sports and play with his friends and things like that. I don't know if kids are physically ready for wearing pads and things of that nature until a certain age.
Injury and concussion fears continue to lead the way football's declining numbers. Football leagues at all levels, including the NFL, continue to change rules and teach the game to make it more safe.
I think we're extremely, extremely cautious with injuries, particularly head injuries. The equipment's better than it's ever been. I think all teams around the country hit less than they ever hit in practice.
Experts say kids are getting injured in all sports, including bicycling, which sends nearly as many kids to the hospital as football injuries. Schell has been around football for over 30 years. Does he expect a shrinking number trend to continue, ultimately ruining America's favorite game?
I'm afraid the state of football in America is going to decline a little bit. Maybe go to not 11-man teams, but maybe 9-man teams, or even less like it is in Texas.
We caught up with a couple of current DFL players for their thoughts.
Yeah, a lot of my friends' parents, they think they'll get like really hurt and get concussions and stuff.
A lot of my friends say their parents won't let them, so.
This will be an interesting trend to follow. Be sure to follow your Celtics Fridays. They travel to Derby. For DJ TV, I'm Hayden Schell.
And I'm Carson Rangel, signing off.
Wow, the future's in good hands, I can tell you that much.
No doubt about that, Cod. Next, let's watch this video on the woolly mammoth committed to Purdue here at Dublin Jerome.
First name Cam, last name Craig. The man, the myth, the legend. Let's see how big this meese can get at the Purdue University.
Too long living in the same old lines. Yeah, I feel too Will you walk the line like it's there to choose?
It's kind of sophomore year. I hit a big growth spurt. I was like 6'3", but I was still skinny, so I just hit the weight room and ate a lot. Just try to play as soon as I can and keep good grades and get my school paid for. Obviously, playing football and just, you know, going to college and meeting new people and experiencing new things. You know, I just like the coaches. You know, West Lafayette's a good place, and I think it's going to be a good program in years to come. I want to be a part of it. I just like the program. You know, the coaches were cool. West Lafayette's a cool place, and I'm just excited to go there.
That's a wrap, Kelt.
Before you go, check out these top plays from our CSPN studio.